Corrosion control. Corrosion of a metal is a natural spontaneous process by which a metal is converted into a more stable compound. Therefore, corrosion control is more realistic than corrosion prevention. The corrosion types are so numerous, the mechanism of corrosion are so different, and the condition under which corrosion takes place are so varied that no single method can be used to control all possible corrosion cases. The choice of control method depends upon the factors such as type of structure and the nature of prevailing corrosion and the residual stress in the fabricated articles, the nature of the environmental and the similar other factors. So these are the broader picture for corrosion control. We will discuss now one by one what are the corrosion control methods. Metallic coating, deposition of a protective metal over the surface of a base metal is called metallic coating. It is a valuable and well-tried method for improving the corrosion life of the underlying metal. Metal coatings are applied by electro deposition, flame spraying, cladding, hard dipping, diffusion coating, and vapor deposition. From the corrosion point of view, metal coatings can be divided into two classes, anodic coatings and cathodic coatings. Now we will discuss one by one anodic coating as well as cathodic coating. Anodic coating. Anodic coatings are produced by a coating of base metal with more active metals such as zinc, magnesium, aluminium or iron. In this case, zinc, magnesium, aluminium acts as anode and base metal like iron acts as cathode. As long as zinc, magnesium, aluminium will be there, we can prevent the corrosion it is. The exposed surface of the metal is cathodic with respect to the coating metal, and the coating metal preferentially undergoes corrosion. The production is ensured as long as anodic coating metal is still present on the surface. Therefore, anodic coating is also known as sacrificial coating. Galvanization is a familiar example for anodic coating and is extensively used to protect iron and steel objects. Cathodic coating. Cathodic coatings are produced by coating a base metal with a more noble metal which acts as cathode. The metals such as copper, nickel, tin, silver are commonly used as a cathode coatings on the steel. These coating metals are less reactive than a base metal and are less susceptible for corrosion. The cathodic coatings provides protection only when it is undamaged, continuous and non-porous. When the coating is discontinuous, an intense localized corrosion occurs due to large cathodic area and small anodic area. Example, tinning. Now we will discuss one by one, that is anodic coating. Example, galvanization. Galvanization is a process of coating zinc on iron or steel article. It is an example of anodic metal coating. As zinc has a relatively low melting point, around 419 degrees centigrade, galvanization is usually done in by hard dipping process. The picture shows a typical galvanization process. Galvanization process can be carried out because it is low cost and ease of application. Galvanization is carried out by hard dipping methods. The galvanization process involves the following steps. Before coating on zinc over iron, the metal to be treated properly. If the impurities present on the surface must be removed by step by step. Initially, the metal surface is washed with organic solvents to remove organic matter on the surface. This process is known as degreasification. As the name indicates, we are removing the grease material or any other organic material on the surface of metal. Later, rust and other deposits are removed by washing with dilute sulfuric acid. This process is known as pickling process. In the next stage, the article is then dipped in a bath containing molten zinc maintained at 425 to 430 degrees centigrade and covered with a flux of ammonium chloride to prevent the oxidation of molten zinc. The excess of zinc on the surface is removed by passing through a pair of hot rollers, which wipes out excess of zinc coating and produces a thin coating. Galvanization is used extensively to protect iron from corrosion in the form of roofing sheets, fencing wires, buckets, bolts, nuts, screws, pipes, etc. Galvanized steel reinforcements are used in building constructions where high degree of corrosion resistance is required. One important note here, galvanized articles, however, are not used for preparing food stuffs, since zinc dissolves in dilute acids producing zinc compounds which are toxic in nature. Now we will discuss tinning method. Tinning is a process of coating tin on iron by hard dipping methods. Tinning of mild steel is done mostly for the requirements for foodstuff industry, like in the manufacture of cans, containers for storing ghee, foodstuffs, oils, pickles and packed food material. This is probably due to non-toxic nature of tin and also due to its resistance against atmosphere. Similar to galvanization process, in this process also the coating material is treated with like organic solvents as well as sulfuric acid to remove the impurities present in it. That process is known as pre-treatment process. So these are the common steps involved in the tinning process. First, degreasification followed by pickling. During tinning, the object is first cleaned and the cleaned object is passed through a molten zinc chloride flux, molten tin and then through palm oil. Zinc chloride flux helps in better adherence of coating and palm oil prevents the oxidation of hot tin coating by air. A pair of rollers inside the palm oil tanks helps in removing the excess of tin and producing a coating of uniform thickness. Application wise, tin coated steel is used for manufacturing containers.